Hello, I'm Lotus Smits for the Capital Network. Joining me at Hong Kong Mines and Money is the Managing Director of Galaxy Resources, Anthony C. Anthony, welcome.
Good morning.
Now, lithium is the commodity everyone wants to know about. Can you explain what your outlook is for this booming commodity and based on what factors?
I think it's going to be a very interesting next 5 to 10 years in terms of demand growth. Lithium, as we all know, is very prevalent in our consumer electronics. So whether they're laptops, iPads, or our smartphones, all use lithium as a preferred technology. And you know, that's already a very burgeoning sector. However, there's a lot more new growth coming online as we speak right now, especially in the electric vehicle sector, where we're seeing a huge increase in adoption rates across the world. Last year, the world sold about 780,000 electric vehicles. But a lot of that growth is coming from North Asia and specifically China. China itself sold over 500,000 vehicles. And all of those are using lithium batteries.
Okay, so you talk about this increasing demand, obviously with more competition entering into the market.
Sure.
Where do you think that Galaxy Resources is going to find its competitive advantage in this marketplace?
Sure, so we have a very interesting portfolio of assets. So we have two hard rock lithium projects, one in Australia, one in Canada, and a third brine project in Argentina. We are currently in production on our Australian asset, and that's generating some very healthy cash flows for us. And that puts us in a very good position to actually fund our other development projects going forward as we look to bring on more capacity.
Okay, well, that's a good update on what's happening with Galaxy Resources. Now, looking ahead, what can shareholders look forward to as far as milestones in the coming 6 to 12 months?
I think Mount Catlin beginning to perform at capacity and improving grades there. Obviously, we're stepping into our new 2017 contracts and pricing environment now, which is again approximately a 50% uplift from where we were last year in terms of pricing. So that's going to be generating some very good margins for us. And our two other projects, James Bay in Canada and Sal de Vida in Argentina, will be going through the next stage of development. So James Bay will be completing its DFS, and Sal de Vida, we're having discussions with off-takers and potential financiers on how to advance that project going forward.
Well, lots to look forward there, and I know that it's a very busy schedule for you. It has been while you've been at Mines and Money as well. Can you explain why you love coming to this conference and what keeps you so busy here?
Sure. I mean, there's a lot of investors and some of our shareholders come regularly to this event. And so for us, it's a good opportunity to catch up with everyone in one place. And obviously, we can also get a sense of other initiatives and exciting things happening in our industry.
Wonderful. Well, thank you for the update on Galaxy Resources today at Mines and Money.
Great. You're welcome.